Okay, so what we have here is the wooden waterfall. Now, I really liked how this turned out. It looks pretty nice at a distance too. But that was a pretty tricky build actually, trying to get all the wood down right, and I'm not quite sure what that's supposed to be there. I never really noticed it before. And what we're actually standing on is a viewing area just for the waterfall. As odd as that sounds, this is a little mountain here, just kind of hanging around doing nothing. Here I made some ladders going down on both sides, kind of a weird design, but I'm trying to be careful. I don't want to fall and go splat. But here, there we go. See, I used glowstone a lot in these early builds. I was addicted to it. Now here's my village. Now I made this before NPC villages even existed. I always thought Minecraft needed more like natural occurrences. So this was one of mine, and I actually like this. It looks like a simple, primitive little village with all the the dirt gravel on the floors show where the ground's been trodden in at, and the little gravel pit there. But moving on. As you can see over in the distance there, we have the sword where my original diamond sword's laid to rest. I don't know if it's the very first diamond sword I had, I'm not sure. But it's one of them. So this was a little pathetic attempt at a bridge I made. This was the proper one. The word WTF comes to mind. What the bloody hell is going on here? Okay, my only answer to this is if you were to spawn a oh, this is too weird. If you were to spawn a world with the seed Paula's World, like I did in 1.8, you would appear in a pine tree forest, I reckon. Because if I recall, that is what it is, next to a swamp. So a pine tree forest and a swamp. And because pine trees are now areas where it snows, they are now snow biomes. I reckon that is the cause of this. That's the only explanation. And this is really weird because my world's changing around me, like literally, in very, very weird ways. Don't get me wrong, I think it's cool, but anyway, I'll tackle that in a moment. This was my underwater observatory. Again, this was before I could make circles and domes. So what we have here is a square. But here you can come down and watch the squids, but as soon as I met, oh, there's one. There you go, you can watch the sheep from underwater. How bizarre. So this was a tough build because I kept drowning. I think this was the only time I've ever put the game on peaceful, just so I could work underwater without fear of death. While I'm down here, I'll show you something else quickly before this all gets frozen over. I hope that don't get frozen over, that would suck. So there's the sword, and I eventually added the tip of it piercing through the sand and stone. Now around here, as soon as I get to it, swim bob, swim bob, swim bob. Here we go. Now this was my first fail attempt at a dry dock boat launcher. Problem is you need sticky pistons. What don't I have? Slimes. So I kind of knackered that idea. But basically, The idea was this would drop down, your boat would go in there, it would come back up, you could walk off, and then you'd hit another trigger, you'd get back in the boat, hit another trigger, and more pistons here release water, which would send you back out. I'm a redstone newbie. There you go. It's still. That still happens. But, if you were to go on there with a boat, you would die. Don't ask me why, but that's how it is. You die. I'm not quite sure what the reason is. Down here we have all the circuitry. Do not ask me what any of it does. I have no idea. I basically just looked up a design someone did and tried to try and replicate it. Oh, not here too. It's like the. Oh, this is crazy. It's like the Lich King's been let loose upon my world. Right. While we're down here. This is a weird area. When looking around my home up there, I accidentally fell down a little hole. It was quite deep, in fact, and I landed in this little area which was filled with mushrooms. So what I ended up doing was turning this place into my tree farm, which has served me very, very well. I mean, I'm always down here chopping trees whenever I'm at this end of the woods. But over here as well we have our. Okay, this was probably my first proper design, or second proper design with I mean, this is probably my best work with redstone. You see that? You got a drawbridge. That's about it. And in the dark here we have our mushroom farm, but there's not really much to show in there. This is here in case any mobs spawn. They can take a walk out and fall down into the pit, you know. That was the idea. Glowstone, glowstone, glowstone. Now this was my Zen garden, which always used to spawn a zombie up here without fail. So it wasn't very peaceful, but I don't know. I like the look of it. I started putting lapis down there, but I might take it out. You don't really see it. And this was my food storage area. Although now you have water leaking through the roof. Plenty of soup. Pork chops. Bread. Cooked fish. I don't think I've ever caught a fish. And cake and cookies. I mean, yeah, I never got around to filling this, although there's plenty of food in there. So, left by a mysterious Spanish gentleman. Some people have asked me about this. This is actually, there's a little web series, a gaming review show, where a guy called Yahtzee reviews games in a very, very funny and rude manner. And when he reviewed Minecraft, that was just a something he said, and I wanted to quote it and put it in here. So if you haven't seen it, go check out Zero Punctuation. Definitely one of the best web series online, in my opinion. Very, very funny. Happy birthday, creepers. Yes, when I built this sand fortress, it was actually the birthday of creepers when they were put in the game. This sand fortress was kind of built here just so I could get into a fight. You know, if I ever wanted to come out and battle, I could without fear of wrecking builds. Down here is a little storage area with a door to the underbelly. Not too much down here. Sadly, it caught on fire once, hence why there's all sandstone and glass for the floor, because of the lava on the other side. Yeah, it's kind of weird. But it happens, you play with fire, stuff gets burnt. So I'm gonna move this on since it's getting dark. Course you can't sprint when running downstairs. We've got all the cacti here to stop horrible mobs when I'm out here. fact, while I'm down here, show you this. This is the entrance to the Nether. As you can see, I wanted to give the effect of the Nether seeping through to this world. Let's take a quick ride. Now, I haven't really done much in the Nether, to be totally honest. Now, I started on this, which was supposed to be a tower, but this was before I could do circles, so it turned out to be a giant square tower, which isn't very good, and beyond that, there's really not much else out here. The next world, I plan on building a proper Nether. I plan on building proper Nether builds, including a Nether walkway and stuff. So that is on the that is the cards on the table. However the expression goes, I don't know. Sprint, sprint, sprint. I added this little fence here to keep me safe. Now on my luck, I'll run up here and face to face with a creeper. This was my original farm, it served me well. Had so many bloody sheep spawn in here and trample everything. Has gotten tiring. And this is my original home. Let me just show you. Hey boy. So this was one of the first proper houses I built in Minecraft. In fact, it was the first proper house I built in Minecraft. Over the time, little bits and pieces have been added. Up here we have my jacuzzi, as you do, and here's my bed. The only time I've ever used bookshelves. I really would like to use them more, but... And this little material is furnaces. I just want to point that out because of how many materials they took up. But yeah, they are furnaces. They line the outside of this house, but now you don't really see them, so it was kind of pointless. But it looks nice from outside. Again, this was all built with Doku Craft in mind. Down here, we have our little storage room where we've got all sorts of bits and pieces and wonderful junk here and there. Diamond. So, let's go ahead and make it daytime. Since we're here. There we go, morning, lovely. Hey boy, I'll be back. So, this was the little entrance. I never finished this, which is surprising to me because as much as I really like this house, I never finished it. Like the front of it just unfinished. What's going on? That's what I mean when I say I'm slacking. Down here you can see the mine shaft. I'll show that in a moment. This was a glowstone tower, as I like to call it, when I was trying to build a tower. And I was obsessed with glowstone, as you can see. Although I'm happy with it because you get a really good view of the surroundings. You can see the waterfall in the distance with the villages. Now you get to see the big sword there. And there's the Bastion Project and there's my home. So this was Glowstone Tower. We're going to head over to the Bastion Project here in a moment. One of the final builds to show you. This is sad. This was my first wolf I had and he took out like two zombies and then a third jumped him and I forgot to heal him. That was my fault. So there was in fact, I think a creeper took him out. I can't remember. Or I don't remember, I should say. Down here in this little well, you have the entrance to my mine. Now most of the people are smart, they use strip mining and all sorts. Not me. Not me. In fact, I don't think I've even got a water ladder in this world. That's how bad it is. And I'm not sure why I never had one here. Careful. It's always on fire. Not much down here. It's just like huge open spaces of where I've been mining to get my diamonds and such. But yeah, this. Oh, I figured I'd show you this just because if you decide to use my world to actually play in, here's a mine all waiting for you. Oh my God. Oh my God, baby Jesus. I did not want to see that when coming up these ladders. And here I am telling you, here's a mine for you. It's like trying to sell a house which has some dark secret, like an Indian graveyard underneath the floorboards or in the basement. Anyway. Oh Lord, the ice is spreading. This is pretty crazy. I'm expecting it to snow next. So in here we have a little tunnel. There, that's under construction still. There's still a few hidden signs left here and there for when I first release my world, if you haven't found them yet. This was a nice viewing tower. Up there just leads you to the top of this little mountain. Here you get a nice view of everything. And here we have our cart to the Bastion Project. Now, obviously by its name, this was inspired by the game Bastion. It is an awesome game and I just loved it. And this project was never really finished, but what I've got so far looks pretty good to me, although you have to be pretty careful. Here we've got the waterfall. Now this was the start of a tree I was building. However, I cannot build trees if you haven't noticed. So we have a very, very square looking tree. And because I hit the height limit, you can't finish the top. So this is a weird, really weird tree. But let me look where I'm going. I'm kind of nervous walking up backwards when I'm up here. So this is a multi-level floating island, as in you can take these steps and go around. And I love the natural look it has. Although it doesn't really go anywhere, that was the problem. I mean, you go to here, you get a dead end, but you do have some floating trees. I think the next time I start a new Bastion project, or anything up in the sky, I'll use vines. This was my little storage area. As you can see, a little glass floor, using that again. So over here, one of the big features of this area was I wanted to have vines coming down, hiding this sort of bridge. But there was no vines in the game at the time, so I started using leaves. And then after I finished this, like immediately after, Notch announces vines for the game. It's kind of annoying, but I don't know. One day maybe I'll revisit it and tidy it up. So, oh Lord, heading towards, trying to head round to the sword and it starts raining and I see it snowing here. And this is weird because this completely changes everything I have built in this area. In fact, it may even ruin it some because it's going to completely hide a lot of what's happened here. And the only reason it's doing it here is because this is like an original Minecraft generated world, you know, one of the early versions. I mean, at least it's raining here, but all that's going to be covered in snow, and that's kind of crazy. I mean, don't get me wrong, it will look cool, I hope, but it's just weird. But here we have some more bridges I made. My first attempt at a bridge. Kind of tried to blend it in. I just can't believe it's snowing. I can't believe that's going to be all iced over. What a change. Oh well. Over here, we have my memorial to my first diamond sword, as you lot have seen already. But let me just quickly show you. If you climb up here, You have a lone chest at the foot of this sword, foot of this weapon, and in it is buried my diamond sword. Wow. That is wild. I probably should check out the Bastion project as well once it's finished. The snowy aftermath. Anyway, we're gonna quickly go up here. There is actually an underground tunnel leading to this little home. This was basically the first area, the first thing I built. This was the little marker before I set off, but down here is my very, very first spawn point and home. From episode 1. I started here and I'm exactly welcome to Paul's world. Immediately I liked it because we had this little secret entrance here and the back way out there where a creeper attacked me. Then here we just have a little simple shelter. This was where I spent my first night. If you go that way you'll come across into the middle of that deserty area, which is probably going to get snowed over now. But yeah, this was where I started. So I'm gonna wrap it up here, I think. So my world's gonna change now because it's snowing, so that's weird. Anyway, I just wanna thank all of my viewers. Thank you so much for watching this series, because I didn't expect to get as many views as I have on any of my videos. So from someone who's like really quiet normally in real life, to do these videos is, you know, something I never really expected to do. So again, thank you so much. Now stay tuned, there's going to be plenty more coming for Paul's World and other Minecraft series. Because this episode's gone on a bit too long, I'm going to save the special build till next episode, so stick around for that. I'm sure you've had enough of my voice by now. It's going dark, lovely. This world map will be online. Please check the description for the download, or go to paulie.com, and you're welcome to come join our Minecraft server at ashleshq.com. Once again, thank you for watching and sticking with my world. Goodbye. Creeper face.